Hello children, welcome back to our class. Today we are going to learn the grammar part from unit 1 of your course book, that is section 3, vocation poem. From that page number 32 you have to open from your course book. Okay children, from course book 32 page number you open, the grammar we will learn. Firstly, what adjectives are, about that we are going to read today. So firstly, I will explain about the adjective form or the pattern what is used in this poem. Okay, the quality, what it has been shown, or the character. We can say the quality, the quantity which describes, it is adjective, as you all know, you have studied. I will just define that and say the common thing what we use as a rule. Okay.
Adjectives. An adjective is a word that describes a noun or pronoun. Example, we saw lazy lions beneath a shady tree. Adjectives tell what kind, how many, and which one. So children, adjective describe particularly noun and pronoun, and it tell what kind of thing it is, what kind of person they are, how many people are, or how many things are there, and which one actually it is. For example, lazy lions, 3 adults, that tree. 4 grey bucks are in the small garden. The mighty elephant pushed aside the large boulder. So these are the examples of the quality, the quantity, particular thing, what it is about. Okay children, I hope you understood what adjective is particularly. Predicate adjective. So, here you will learn one more thing, predicate adjectives. An adjective that appears in the predicate after the verb is predicate adjective. You can also say that a predicate adjective is an adjective that follows a link verb, or we can say a linking verb, and describes the subject of a sentence. Okay, children? For forms of the predicate adjective are, forms of be are the most common linking verbs. Be, is, am, are, was, were. Other linking verbs are look, taste, smell, feel, appear, seem, become. Adjective can make comparison. Yes, children, even adjective can make comparison. Comparative things, or the comparative words which are been used in adjectives are, most adjective add er to compare two nouns. Okay, children, for example, today is hotter than yesterday. So, how did we compare the thing? The day, the present day is hotter than the past day. Okay. So, hot has been changed, or the word added here is hotter. That is er. Okay. The superlative form is, most adjectives add est to compare three or more nouns. This is the hottest day of the year. So, what kind of day it is, children? Hottest. In comparative form, we will use most, whereas we will add er, and in superlative form, we will use in adjectives est. Okay, you have come to know hotter and hottest. These are the example. Okay, children. Now, the next one, other comparison. Okay, use more or less to form the comparative of most adjective with two or more syllables. Okay, children? Use most or least to form the superlative of most adjectives with two or more syllables. Example, wonderful, more wonderful, most wonderful. Wonderful, less wonderful, least wonderful. Special forms that changes the spellings, much, more, most. Bad, worse, worst. Good, better, best.
We will learn about the textbook examples or what are the adjectival words being used in your textbook. That's in your poem vocation. So see children, in the poem it is being used. Writing adjective, noun poem. The poem is mainly based in the noun form. But here we have seen few subjects like the season, summer. Okay, about summer it is being spoken. And here we list some associated nouns, that is morning, afternoon, evening, night. Okay, in this poem we have seen this associative noun, that is morning, afternoon, evening and night. Okay, not only this, we even describe few things here in this poem, that is the adjective to describe the noun, means noun words are there, that is described by what form it is been shown here. See here, for example, hot, cool, pleasant, humid, warm. The summer, about the summer, it is been spoken. So how the summer will be hot or the temperature will be humid. Okay, about that in this form it is spoken. And even the evening time, how it will be cool, or the day may be pleasant. About that, all this in this poem it is been spoken. So this is adjectives which are described in noun form. Okay children, so this was the pattern of adjective noun of vocation poem. Got it children? Why did we learn today adjectives? Okay, now we will read figures of speech. Okay children, now you have learned about the adjectival form, what it is and its definition. Now you are going to learn about the figures of speech, from which the poets enhance the intelligence or the beauty of the poet. Okay, they characterize by using these figures of speech. We call it as poetic device. Okay children, now what figures of speech is, about that you will study first, then which figures of speech it is, that also you will learn. Okay, okay. Now, firstly, we will study about figure of speech, what it is particularly. A figure of speech is a departure from the ordinary form of expression or the ordinary course of idea in order to produce a greater effect. What does it mean? A figure of speech is a departure from, means the deliberation or the explanation which is given by the poet in ordinary words. It has been enhanced or been highlighted with this poetic device. In us, his ideas or his course of idea is being producing greater effect. Okay, by using this poetic device. Okay children, this was the definition of figure of speech. Now you will learn about the poetic device. Which poetic device is used in this poem? It is simile. So what simile is, that you will learn. So particularly which, what we call this simile as the poetic device which is used by the poet Rabindranath Tagore in this poem, that is simile. In simile, a comparison is made between two objects of different kind which have however at least one point in common. Okay children, what particular simile is? The comparison between two different things, but it has one common character or one common part. Okay, so particularly how we can identify the sentence is simile. Okay, the simile is usually introduced by word such as, what it is made, how it is identified, like, as or so. I'll repeat once again children. A simile is usually introduced by words such as like, as or so. For example, as proud as peacock. What did we use here? As. What it is proud of? Peacock is proud of. Okay. As proud as peacock. The another example is as good as gold. What the quality is been shown here? Gold is precious, is it? So, as good as gold. Okay. I hope you all understood what adjective is and what simile is. Okay children, In this poem, you are learning only these two grammar parts. Okay, one is figure of speech and another is adjective. Got it, children? Okay, thank you.